students, good morning and welcome to the new episode of our English class. Till the 36th episode we completed our second term text and today we are moving on to the third term text. Okay, our third term text has came and today we are moving on to the first lesson from the third term text, that is A Cross Line. First lesson is the Cross Line. Clothes line. I hope all of you did your exams in a pleasant way and the paper are coming to us. We'll check it out and the proper support will give to you. Okay, I hope all of you are safe at home and wish you all the very best for your third term and today. Now let us start our first chapter, that is the clothes line. Take page number 7, all of you take your text. Take page number 7. In page number 7 there is an ornament segment, that is clothes when washed are hung on the clothesline to dry. Whenever our clothes are washed, we used to hang it in a clothesline. Ropes are used, plastic or kayak ropes are used to make a clothesline. And whenever the windy season comes, that means whenever there is wind, we used to clip the clothes in the clothesline. Otherwise, it will fly away from there due to wind. Okay, all of you know. Clothes, when washed, are hung on the clothesline to dry. For what purpose we are hanging the clothes on the clothesline? For drying the clothes after washing. Sometimes when the clothes are not clipped, they fly off. That means the clips are available in the market and we are used to buy the cloth clips to hang it or clip the clothes along with the cloth line. Sometimes whenever we miss to clip the clothes in the cloth line, what will happen? They will fly from the cloth line and they will fall into the ground. Sometimes when the clothes are not clipped, they fly off. They will fly off. Have you ever wondered where do they fly? Do you notice where do they fly? On the handkerchief below. Here is a handkerchief. The picture of a handkerchief is given here and two flowers are there in two corners and on the handkerchief below, make your favorite drawing and color it. In olden days, at our childhood days, we are making handkerchief by ourselves. Taking a piece of cloth, stitch the four sides of the cloth and using some thread, we can make our favorite flowers or favorite leaves on that, or favorite pattern on that kerchief. Okay, nowadays you are staying at home and you take a fresh piece of cloth and make a handkerchief by yourself. That is a task given to you. And if you are able to make a better handkerchief or good handkerchief, you can send the photo to me. Okay, then you can polish your abilities, polish your capability for stitching, then sewing and all these things. Colorful threads are available in the market and you buy some. You ask your parent to buy some embroidery threads and using the embroidery needle, you can stitch some patterns in the piece of cloth and make it a favorite handkerchief. If you want to give it as a gift to your beloved ones, you can also gift it. Okay, you make a beautiful handkerchief and give it to your mother, father or your relative as a birthday gift or a anniversary gift, etc. Okay, then here we have a piece of handkerchief, in page number 7, and you can draw some pictures on it or some patterns on it and make it a colorful handkerchief. Here the instruction is to make it a colorful handkerchief. Is it clear? Let us move on to the lesson, page number 8. It's a poem. The clothesline is a poem, a P-O-E-M, poem. It's a poem. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hither, thither, to and fro, flip, flop, flop, and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. Hand in hand they dance in a row, whenever we the cloth lines. Some pants are there, trousers are there, leggings are there, then pinafores are there, your uniforms are there, handkerchiefs are there, and the undergarments are there. All the garments were put on a cloth line, put on a cloth line for drying. We, after washing the clothes, we always put the clothes on a cloth line for drying. Then they hand in hand they dance in a row. Whenever there is wind, that will flutter to and fro. To and fro means to the front and the back. Towards and backwards. Towards and backwards. They are dancing. They are hanging in a row. Look at this picture. This is the picture of a cross line. Cross line. Whenever after washing the cross, we hang it. If it is a scarf, we hang it in the cross line. And some handkerchief where we are handkerchiefs. The other side, there will be the other side, some flowers are there in handkerchief. Like that, we have some trousers are there. Some trousers are there. The clothes they are hang on a cloth line. The clothes after washing, the clothes they are hang on a cloth line. And they hand in hand dance in a row. They are arranged in a row. They are arranged in a row. And they are putting their hand in hand, their arms in a row. Whenever the wind blows, it comes to the front, to come towards you and then backwards to in front of you and go backwards. That is, they hand in hand, they dance in a row. When we look from far away, hand in hand, they dance in a row. Hither and thither, to and fro. How did they dance? Hither and thither. Hither and thither means here and there. Here and there. Hither and thither means here and there. To and fro. They are dancing to and fro. And here and there. They are fluttering here and there. The clothes that they are hang on a cloth line, they are dancing in the wind. They are putting their hands in hands and they are dancing in the wind. And they are dancing to and fro and hither and thither. Hither and thither means here and there. Hither and thither. It's an old English usage. Hither and thither. Hither and thither. What is the meaning of hither and thither? Here and there. Hither and thither means here and there. To and fro, towards and backwards. To and fro means towards and backwards. Flip, flop, flop, and away they go. Whenever the cloth is wet, it has a makes a sound. Whenever the cloth is dry, it makes another sound. Whenever it is wet, it like flip, flap, flop. That means it is flying. And away they go. Away they go. They are coming towards us. And away they go. When another wind came, they go away from us. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. Whenever we look it from far away, we are seeing it as fluttering creatures. Creatures means living things. Fluttering creatures. Fluttering means moving. Fluttering. F-L-U-T-T-E-R-I-N-G. Fluttering means moving. F-L-U-T-T-E-R-I-N-G. Fluttering. F-L-U-T-T-E-R-I-N-G. Fluttering creatures. C-R-E-A-T-U-R-E-S. Creatures. C-R-E-A-T-U-R-E-S. Creatures. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. As white as snow means we can see snow. That means clouds, snowy clouds are there in the sky and they are moving here and there. And they are very snow white means it is very pleasant to look. Snow white. It's a color. Snow white color. It is very pleasant to see. And these clouds are flying like fluttering creatures that are as white as snow. That means snowy white is very pleasant to look. And these crows are fluttering creatures. These crows are moving pictures and they are asked white as snow. They are seen as white as snow. They are seen as white as snow. Okay, look. Hand in hand they dance in a row. This is the first stanza. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hither and thither, to and fro, flip flop flop, and away they go. Flip flop flop and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. And read once again, you please listen. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hand in hand they dance in a row, hither and thither, to and fro. How did they dance? They dance hither and thither, to and fro. Flip flop flop, away they go. Flip flop flop and away they go. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. Okay, let us move on to the next paragraph. Next stanza. Like rusty horses they caper and prance. Like rusty horses, R-A-S-T-I-V, rusty means restless.
In the fairy tales, there may be some witches.
witches, wicked fairies are called witches. W-I-T-C-H-E-S, witches. W-I-T-C-H-E-S, witches. Witches. Bad fairies, wicked fairies are called witches. Like fairy tale witches, they wildly dance. The clothes that were hung on a clothesline in heavy wind, what did they do? They dance like a fairy tale witches. Heavy steps are there, heavy dance are there, and they are dancing in storms. That means a heavy wind. At the time of heavy wind, what did the clothes do? The clothes that were hung on a clothesline will dance heavily, wildly dance, wildly. W-I-L-D-L-Y, wildly. W-I-L-D-L-Y. The clothes that were hung on a clothesline will wildly dance. When they wildly dance? They dance wildly like fairy tale witches when there is heavy wind. When at the time of heavy wind, these clothes were dancing like fairy tale witches with the wild steps, with wild steps. Okay. Look at the two lines. Like rusty horses, they caper and prance. Like rusty, rusty means restless. Like rusty horses, they caper and prance. Like fairy tale witches, they wildly dance. These clothes wildly dance. Rounded in front but hollow behind. They were rounded in front. R-O-U-N-D-E-D, rounded. R-O-U-N-D-E-D. That means rounded in front and hollow at back. Hollow means empty space. H-O-L-L-O-W, hollow. H-O-L-L-O-W, hollow. Whenever the wind comes, they are rounded. Suppose this is a cross, and whenever wind is blowing, it is rounded in front. The middle part comes to the front. They rounded in front, and then there is a hollow part behind it. Then there is a hollow part behind the cross. Rounded in front and but hollow behind. Behind means at the back side. Behind. B-E-H-I-N-D. Behind. B-E-H-I-N-D, behind, means at the back. They shiver and skip in the merry March wind. They shiver and skip. The clothes shiver. When the wind became heavy, the clothes shiver and skip. The clothes will shiver and skip. When the clothes will shiver and skip? When there is heavy wind come, when there is heavy wind, the clothes will shiver. Shiver means shivering, waving with the fear or anger, that is shivering, waving with fear or anger, that is, it is waving, trembling, shivering means trembling, T-R-E-M-B-L-I-N-G, trembling. The clothes are shivering and skipping, S-H-I-V-E-R, shiver, yes, H-I-V-E-R, shiver, S-H-I-V-E-R, shiver. The clothes are shivering and skipping. Skipping, we can know skipping rope. You see, they are skipping. That means moving. These are the different kinds of moving. Dancing, then fluttering. Then what is the other one? Caper and prance. Then wildly dance. Then make a round at the front and hollow at the back. And then it is shivering and skipping. The clothes are shivering and skipping. Skipping, these are kinds of movements. They are shiver and skip in the merry March wind. When the wind is very merry, it will shiver and skip. Shiver and skip. Okay, I will read that two stanzas together. You please listen to the text. Hand in hand they dance in a row, here and to the to and fro, flip flap flow, and away they go, fluttering creatures, as white as snow. Here, the clothes are referred to as fluttering creatures. The clothes are described as fluttering creatures, and they are as white as snow. They look like snow white. They look like in snow white color. Like Rusty, the horse is referred to as. The clothes are referred to as rusty horses. The clothes are described as rusty horses. Like rusty horses, they keep on dance. They move and dance playfully. They move and dance playful manner. They move and dance in playful manner. The resting horses, they caper and prance like fairy tale witches. They wildly dance like fairy tale witches. They wildly dance, rounded in front but hollow behind. Rounded in front but hollow behind. They shiver and skip in the merry march wind. They shiver and skip in the merry march wind. Okay, let us move on to the new words from this part. First one, hither and thither. First word is hither and thither. It is an usage that means here and there. Hither and thither means here and there. Then fluttering, moving, fluttering.
One cloth
among the other clothes. That means so many clothes were hanging on the clothesline, and one among the clothes. What is it doing? It is dancing with excitement, heavy excitement. It is dancing excitedly, in an excited manner it is dancing and struggling so wildly. Whenever a child is doing some mischief, we will caught him. We will catch him. What did he do? He is struggling to free himself. Like that, here the cloth, one of the cloth is dancing excitedly, and it is struggling for what purpose? So wildly till she was free. It is struggling to get free. Whenever a child is running here and there, we are afraid of each fall. Okay, then we will catch him and stop there. We will try to stop him there, and he will struggle and free himself. He will struggle to free himself. Like that, one cloth among them was dancing in an excited manner. For what purpose? It is very dancing wildly or in an excited manner to free himself from there. It is clipped in the cloth's line. And it is moving here and there, fluttering in a wild manner to free himself from the clothesline, to get away from the clothesline. One eye saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free. It struggled till she was free. That means it was a heavy struggling. It struggled. When it stopped, when it became free, it stopped its struggling. Then leaving pegs and clothesline behind her. Pegs means clips, P-E-G-S, pegs. Pegs. P-E-G-S, pegs here means the clips, cloth clips. Nowadays, the windy season is there, and whenever we wash our clothes and hang it on the clothesline, what will we do? We will clip the clothes on the clothesline. Because otherwise, if we will not clip the cloth on the cloth line, it will fall down. Okay, like that. Here, now the cloth is free from the cloth line and the clips. Pegs means clips. Pegs, P-E-G-S. Pegs means clips. Then leaving pegs and cloth line behind her, she flew like a bird. What did that cloth do? The cloth who struggled to free himself. The cloth which struggled and danced excitedly to free herself. When after some time struggling, it freed itself from the clothesline and the clips. It freed itself from the clothesline and the clips. Then what we need to do? It flew away from there. She flew like a bird. What did the cloth do? The cloth flew like a bird. Fly, past tense of fly is flew. F-L-E-W, flew, the past tense of fly. The verb is fly and the past tense is flew. The cloth flew like a bird, free bird. Now the cloth is free. It is not hanged on the cloth line. It is not clipped on the cloth line. So it flew like a bird. It flew like a bird, and no one could find her. And no one could find her. Where it is? Nobody could find the cloth that is freed. It's that freed itself from the cloth line and the clips. It put the cloth line and the clips behind her and fly away from there like a free bird. The cloth fly away from there like a free bird. Okay. And let's have a look at the three stanzas. You please listen to the text. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hither and thither, to and fro, flip flap fro, and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. Like rusty horses they caper and prance, like fairy tale witches they wildly dance, rounded in front but hollow behind, they shiver and skip in the merry March wind. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was pale. Then leaving pets and claws lying behind her, she flew like a bird and no one could find her. She flew like a bird and no one could find her. Once again, hand in hand they danced narrow, hither and thither, to and fro, flip-flop, and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. Like rusty horses they caper and prance, like fairy tale witches they wildly dance. Round in front but hollow behind, they shiver and skip in the merry nostrils. One he saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free. Then leaving pecks and claws lines behind her, she flew like a bird and no one could find her. Okay, then the most important thing is text reading. It's a poem and the video will come to you soon. And on the same day, you read this poem 2 or 3 times, and whenever you read it fluently, you take an audio of that and send it to me in a WhatsApp along with your copywriting. Okay, you are writing the poem, begins to write the copy, and whenever the video comes to you, you read the text very carefully. And otherwise, if you don't read the text, it will be very hard for you to learn. Text reading help you to learn the lesson very easily. Okay, and let us have a look at the new words from this tense. Excitedly, look at the word excitedly. Excitedly, then struggling. That is struggling. 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 Next word pecs. Pecs. Pecs means clicks. Then flew. Past tense of fly is flew. Let us wind up the class today. And the text reading is very important. You read the text and take an audio of that and send it to me in the WhatsApp. Thank you and see you in the next class.